Morning, my dear kids. How are you all? I hope everyone is fine. In the last video or in the last period, I have told you to read the lesson from the class 6 state board and CBSE board. I hope that everybody must have read that lesson. See, light lesson is very important lesson, and see, it is very big, so you have to read all the points every day. You have to recall all the points every day. Okay? In the last video, we have just gone through the types of mirror. I have told you one mirror. Which is this mirror? Yes, this is a plain mirror. Am I right? Which is this mirror? This is a plain mirror. Now see, this is a plain mirror. If you will see, why we can say the mirror is an opaque object. Now see, this is a shiny part. This is a shiny part and this is rough part. Am I right? When you can say it is a mirror, the difference, I will tell you about what is mirror, what is an opaque object, and we have learned about opaque and transparent object. So see, mirror is an opaque object. Am I right? See, if the light is not there, if you don't have any light, can you see the mirror? Can you get your image in the mirror? No, we can't get the image in the mirror. Are you getting? We have also discussed about the characteristics of the plain mirror. Am I right? In the last video, we have discussed about the characteristics of the plain mirror. Now, just tell me, what is this? Which shape is this? Yes, this is a sphere. Which is this sphere? Which is this shape? Yes, it is a sphere. Now, when I will cut this sphere into two equal parts, when I will cut this sphere into two equal parts, I will get this half part. This half part is called as hemisphere. Now, yes, now this, see, this is the outer part and this is the inner part. And both are the reflecting part. Have you seen the spoon? Have you seen the spoon? Now, see, this is what? Spoon, yes. Now, you can see the both the part. One part is curved and another is little bit outer, yes, outer curve. Am I right? So these are the part, these are the part of the spherical mirror. These are the part of the spherical mirror. Are you getting? Now see, if you might have seen the spoon, okay, you can get your image in the spoon. Yes, inward as well as outward. If you will see like this, you can see the image inward, and if you will see from the outside, you can get your image. But there is a difference between the image. Am I right? Yes or no? So see, students, you have to do the activity. You just take the spoon and see your image in the both the side, inward and outward. Now, spherical mirror is a reflecting surface when it is like this, when it is curved. It is like this, and why I have done this? See, this is a rough part, okay? Means the reflecting surface is only on this side. The shiny surface is only on this side, inside side. Okay, now which is this shape? Or what is, which is this shape? Can you recall what is this? It is like a cave, am I right? So it is called as this shape, inward reflecting surface is called as inward, inner reflecting surface. Inner reflecting surface, that mirror is called as a concave mirror. Which mirror? It is called concave mirror. When a reflecting surface is inside, it is called as a concave mirror. Are you getting? When the reflecting surface is inside, then that part, as it is a part of the spherical mirror, as it is a part of the spherical mirror, and the reflecting part is inside, so that mirror is called as a concave mirror. That mirror is called as a concave mirror. Then, now see, the outer part is also a reflecting part. Now if you will see spoon, if you will see the spoon, that is also an outer part. Am I right? You can get your image. Am I right? So like this. Here, reflecting surface is this. Am I right? So this is outer reflecting surface. This is outer reflecting surface. And this is also the part of the spherical. This is also the part of the spherical mirror. Are you getting? So when the outer part is a reflecting surface, that type of the mirror is called as a convex mirror. That type of the mirror is called as a convex mirror. So just can you tell me where these things you have seen, the what are the uses of the concave and convex mirror? Where do we have every day, where do you have seen this type of the mirror? Can you just give me the example? See, concave mirror you might have seen in the torch. If you will observe the torch, see the torch is like this, am I right? So which type of the mirror is used? Concave mirror. Now the headlight of the motorcycle, it is like this, am I right? It is outer, so it is a concave mirror, am I right? Then you have also seen in the dentist uses this concave mirror to see the image enlarged, to see the image enlarged. So dentist uses this concave mirror. Are you getting? Then for shaving purpose we use the concave mirror. So just can you tell me how the image you are getting in the concave mirror? Image in the concave mirror, we get enlarged image. Enlarged means very large image. Are you getting? And the image we get here, it is real image. Now what is real image? Do you know what is meant by the real image? In the last video I have discussed about real and virtual image. In real image is a that type of the image where the rays are get converged at a particular point, where the rays are meeting at a particular point. So that image is called as a real image. We get here image is real. While the image form in a convex mirror is virtual. Now what is virtual? In a plane mirror we get virtual image. See, when you look in the plane mirror, whether you are there actually in the mirror, no, we are not there. It seems to be appear. So that image is called as a virtual image. Like that, in the convex mirror we get the image virtual and inverted. Inverted means upside down. If suppose, what is meant by the inverted? Inverted means suppose the tree is like this. Okay, here you can get the image like this. Inverted, upside down. Upside down you will get the image. That image is called as a inverted image. Are you getting this? So we have learned the two types of mirror. Spherical mirrors are divided into two types, that is concave and convex. Now what is a concave mirror? Concave mirror means the reflecting surface is inside. Inward reflecting surface is called as a concave mirror. Inward reflecting surface is called as a concave mirror. Image you get here, it is real and enlarged in the size, means you get a big image. Are you getting? So where do we use this concave mirror? In the torch, headlight of the motorcycle or the vehicle. Then dentist uses this Dentist uses this mirror, that is concave mirror, to see the particular image, enlarged image. To get an enlarged image, they use the concave mirror. And the next type, that is the if the reflecting surface is outer side, if the reflecting surface is outer side, then that type of the mirror is called as a convex mirror. That type of the mirror is called as a convex mirror. Here we get image, it is a virtual and inverted. Inverted means upside down. And where do we use the convex mirror? Have you ever guessed what are the uses of the convex mirror? Where do we use the convex mirror? See, convex mirrors are used in the mirror of the particular vehicle. Mirror. If you will see the mirror of the particular vehicle, you will see the convex mirror. You will see the convex mirror. It is like this. Am I right? So that type of the mirror is called as a convex mirror. Here we do not see the actual image. Are you getting? We get here virtual image. Are you getting? So today's work will be that you have to remove the notes on the types of the spherical mirror, that is concave and convex mirror. Okay, whatever I have taught you today, just recall all the video and remove the notes on it. Okay, thank you.